Today we're going to show you how to make your KestrelMet 6000 available for public viewing. So first we'll go to the KestrelMet.net website. If you're just starting out, you may not have your device already connected and can see your dashboard. So the first thing we do is go to devices, click the plus, enter your MAC address, and get it onto the KestrelMet.net server. If we go down here under the KestrelMet logo, we put in our location and our time zone. And if we click on the ambient weather, we see that, oh, our same login is available for ambientweather.net. Use the same login, everything. So let's go see what happens when we go to the ambientweather.net login. It may ask for your credentials. Mine are already saved, so it comes in right away. Now, if we go to my dashboard, and if we go to devices this time, we'll notice that there's a new feature under the ambient weather logo. Allow for everyone to see my data. Click on this. And now we could hit the share button and we could send your dashboard link to anyone who wants to see it. So if you have a business partner, family member you want to show, we just paste that in. It takes you right to the dashboard. You don't need a weather meter to get on ambientnet.net, so you could just sign in and log in and just go in. And if you want to find, if you want to make it your favorite, since it's my station, I can't make it a favorite, but if I click on this one, I just click on the star. And now it's in my favorite list, so I could always go back to it. Next, we'll show you how to use Weather Underground. This is a different way to share. It may be more preferable for you, so we'll just walk through that real quick. So we go to the Weather Underground link underneath the icon, and we're going to get an option to add new devices. Now we don't have the KestrelMet 6000 listed yet on Weather Underground, so instead we're going to look for Rainwise Mark IV Cellular. You can add a webcam if you have one. And then we're going to put in our address information. And then you put a name onto it and your elevation, and the device hardware should be already populated. And you can put the height above ground as well. Surface type, I'm not gonna put in here, or I don't have a webcam. So now I'm just gonna accept the terms, go to next. And now I have my station ID and my station key. Now if we go back in the ambient weather, this is what it's looking for, this information. So we could copy and paste it in. But look, oops, it didn't actually add it. So there is about a 10-minute gap between when Weather Underground and Ambient sync up. So it may not work right away. So basically I'm gonna fast forward. I'm gonna go into when it was actually set up. Do connect, and now I'm connected. So now my station is going to be showing on ambientweather.net and weatherunderground.net. Now again, there is some delay in getting all this set up, so it looks like it's still offline for me. But if I click on Joe's device over here, we actually see that we have a connection. So that'll get updated to a green light later at some point when everything kind of clears through the cache system. But here's just a little bit different tiles, different look, different feel to Weather Underground. You may prefer this to the KestrelMet or the Ambient site, that's fine. Again, you can share your Weather Underground login information, and this will show you, you know, graphs of all throughout the different times weekly I could look at. So some people might prefer this, so it's an option as well. So this is how you get set up. You can set, now all your data is being publicly viewed and you can share with anyone else out there.